ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Access 8 Spotlight. Here in the studio with us tonight, we have the Undefeated All Grunt Jungle Band, a group of area musicians who have decided to band together and travel around the country to play and sing out in praise of the Vietnam vet. First of all, let's introduce everybody here. To my left, we have...
Hi, I'm Dan Greenberg from Westbrookville, New York.
What are you doing in the band, Dan?
Lead singer or throat jockey is...
Okay. And next to him, we have...
I'm Don. I play guitar, and I'm the pain in the band, I guess.
Okay, the tape pain. Okay. Caroline.
Caroline Westphal.
I already knew that. No.
Vocals.
Okay. And down the other side, we have...
I'm Glenn. Guitar and keyboard.
I'm Steve Tanzen. I'm Adam Morris. I play the drums.
I'm Dave from Boy Service. I play bass.
Okay. How was the Grunt Band formed?
Well, We have been a band for quite some time, the Sundance, and which is basically the band you see here, minus Frank, of course. And we had, myself being a Vietnam veteran, there was a happening, so to speak, over at Matamoros Airport. Chris Farlick is 10 years ago, who's a columnist, by the way, for the Times Herald Record, had given a party for the Vietnam vets' return. And unfortunately, no one showed up. And that was in 1971, I believe. So we decided to try it again, and a whole bunch of people showed up. Dave Adams, here to my right, happened to hear about this and let us all know about it, and we felt that we'd go down and provide some entertainment for the gathering, and as it turned out, that's how the Grunt Band was formed.
Okay, when did the change from Sundance to the Grunt Band take place, and where did the band first play as the Undefeated All Grunt Jungle Band?
Well, actually, we still do play a lot of local jobs as Sundance, but as far as the Undefeated All Grunt Jungle Band, we had originally, right there at the airport, decided we were going to do something. Someone had mentioned to us there was going to be a gathering of veterans in New York City on May 5th of last year for the City of New York was honoring the Vietnam veterans, having a coming home party maybe a few years late. And we decided to do it, all five of us. On the ship, we met some other fellas who were also musicians, horn players, and that's how the Grunt Band was formed. It was a real special day for everybody here.
Okay. We have with us some footage of the Grunt Band playing on the deck of the USS Intrepid, and we're going to show some of that footage to you right now.
Thank you.
everybody. Welcome back. We hope you enjoyed the footage of the Vietnam Vets Memorial with the Undefeated over on Jungle Band. The footage came to us courtesy of Viet Vets Video, so we'd like to thank them for that. And the next thing I'm going to ask each of you is, starting with Glenn, is how did it feel to play on the Intrepid at the memorial?
Incredible, Frank, let me tell you. Anybody I know has ever played for 10,000 people before, and it was definitely
incredible. Okay,
magical. Steve, I mean, 10,000 people, 20,000 people go to Madison Square Garden to see Motley Crue. What was the difference between something like that and playing at the on the Intrepid at that event?
So Motley
changed.
Difference. There was a feeling of like. Everybody sort of like was looking for each other, and it was weird. Everybody was looking for each other, and they sort of like, in a sense, found them. Everybody was like, it was like one big reunion. So everybody was hugging and singing and dancing and everything.
So it was a lot more emotional.
Yeah, more emotional. A lot of emotion.
Okay. And is that how everybody felt? What was it like? Don, were you scared?
Oh no, I didn't feel scared at all. But I was really excited. We got there very early in the morning, and we waited and watched all the vets come on, and then we. Meeting each other. But the best part was that we didn't expect any of that at all. We just figured it was just, you know, a bunch of guys getting together after 10 years or how many years it was. What, 17 years for some people? 20 years? Quite a few years.
We won't get into that.
Though. I know. And then what happened, and all of a sudden, we start getting chills, we're getting excited, we see people crying, and then we see each other. You know, I start crying. I'm playing. I never felt that emotional in my life. I had my sunglasses on, the tears were coming down underneath.
Wow.
It was incredible.
Yeah.
And for days after, the next day I went home and I was like on a cloud. I went to work.
Yeah.
I couldn't believe it.
That's incredible. Dave, did you experience the same?
Well, yeah. It was similar to a religious experience, but it wasn't a religious experience. It was, we connected with these guys, you know, in an unspoken communication. And seeing what was going on with them after 10 years, you know, down the line, I mean, a lot of my friends went to Vietnam, you know, and we're playing God Bless the USA. I couldn't look at the crowd.
Wow.
You know, I couldn't, if I wanted to keep playing the song, I could not look at them. There was no way.
So that's quite a start for the band's first outing. Where did you go from the Intrepid?
To Stuxnet City Hall.
How did that come about?
Channel 5 filmed this on the Intrepid. We were on the news that night, and they gave the band a call, and they wanted to do a shoot down on steps of City Hall and do interviews for PM Magazine.
Alright.
Because
Memorial Day weekend, right?
Was that Memorial Day?
Yeah, it was.
Weekend,
yeah,
Memorial Day.
That's right.
Yeah.
On that, we sat up on the steps and God, it was so hot that day. Oh, it was 110 in the shade down there. It was terrible.
All right. One thing I got to tell the audience, that we seem to be laughing and joking. I know all these guys, so it's
never seen them before.
Like no. Johnny Carson, you know, they're not being paid to be here. It's like I'm not being paid to do this, so we're gonna loosen this up right now, okay?
Hey, we're dialed up.
Thank God.
Take
my shirt off. All right. Seriously, we have the PM Magazine footage, okay, and we're gonna bring that in right now. And when you come back, this jacket and tie. We'll both be gone.
And don't worry about stress, because nobody here has any stress at all.
Thank you.
Okay.
Everybody, and welcome to Thursday night's edition of PM Magazine. Tonight we are in New York's Vietnam Veterans Memorial. I'm Jill Rappaport.
And I'm Matt Lauer. Now, the memorial is inscribed with letters to and from Vietnam, and since it was dedicated earlier in May, many vets have stopped by, and the response has been a warm and very emotional one. You know, on May 7th, when New York finally did roll out that red carpet for all Vietnam vets,
our ever-vigilant Phantom agent discovered a grunt band that was on a very unusual mission.
While fussing around the pool table at Magoo's Bar in Lower Manhattan, my new pal Buddy Roach talked about the rock band he just formed.
of City Hall. It was their way of thanking New York for its salute to Vietnam War vets back on May 7th. An emotional, albeit delayed, show of appreciation, including a ticker tape parade and a giant deckside reunion on the aircraft carrier Intrepid. It was the Grunt's first ever gig.
It was just an unbelievably emotional experience. I mean, the people were literally standing there crying.
It underscored the emotions of men and women who had been ignored and rejected for serving in an unpopular war.
Grunts are tough, they don't talk about it, you know what I mean? Until something happens like the party at the Intrepid.
His Grunts reunited on the Hudson and marched with their commander through the Canyon of Heroes. Buddy Roach, who had been honored with 4 medals, including the Purple Heart, saw a dream come to life.
25%, one in every four of the combat veterans who returned from Vietnam is dead. That's the highest suicide rate of any group of people anywhere on the face of the earth.
The dream is that Roach and his new band are raising money for Seneca, a non-profit foundation being set up to specifically help the combat vet. The Grunts who tasted fire in Nam.
We came back to not only indifference, but downright hate from some people just because we wore the uniform that served our country.
Lead singer Dan Greenberg also had Sundance, one of the hottest upstate bands. You see, the Undefeated All Grunt Band is made up of vets from other groups. Vets who are platooning for the new campaign.
Now, it's time for healing. It's time for everybody to come together.
Of the murky politics which once diminished their integrity. The all-ground jungle band is having an effect.
If you would have tried to do this 10 years ago, they wouldn't have let you in for it.
I guess it's like that Grunt mentality. It's like, well, you know, we're going back. You know, we got people down, and we're going back. And we know how to do it.
I'm the
studio now, minus jacket and tie, and we hope you enjoyed the PM Magazine footage. The next question I'm going to ask Caroline. Caroline, with the recent Hollywood influx of Rambo-type movies glorifying Vietnam and whatnot, what type of response do you have to anybody that might say that you're a bunch of people that are trying to capitalize on Vietnam? I mean, is there an honest belief and cause in what you're doing as the Grunt Band? Or are you just a bunch of musicians who said, hey, this is hot this year, let's make money off it?
Well, we're obviously not getting rich off of it, and that's not our objective. It's to make people aware of the Vietnam veteran and all veterans, not just of the Vietnam War, and that we do care. Just to make them feel like they are not forgotten. You know, just the fact now when we played out in Colorado and you met these people and you might think, well, we're just a band and when we get paid to go out there and do this. And these people really appreciate this. They really appreciate it and they like to talk about it. They like to talk about it and know that other people do care. So our objective is not to make money. We may get paid for something, but it's to help their cause.
That's great. Okay, in case you're wondering why I asked Caroline as opposed to Danny, who was in Vietnam, I wanted to get the opinion of somebody who was probably 14 years old when Vietnam ended, rather than somebody that was so close to the issue that they were there. Okay. Caroline mentioned playing out in Denver, and we have some footage of that we'll get to in a moment. The first thing I'm going to direct over to, starting over here with Glenn again, and then down the line, has playing in the Grunt Band, how has it affected your life or your outlook on life as opposed to just playing in a Saturday night band? You know, it seems to be a band with a cause. and what are your feelings about that? It's more than just playing for money, Frank, quite simply. We're not just playing for the money. It's not like being a bar band and out for your, $50 a gig or whatever.
Pay your rent.
It's not to pay the rent, it's to let people know that the Vietnam veteran, was very well treated when he got back. And he didn't get his parade when he should have gotten it. And we're just doing our little shows to get them together. And,
for their own little parade, I guess,
Break the ice for them, too.
Absolutely, it is a heartbreaker for them.
Let them know that the generation that they thought had forgotten them really hadn't. Most of us
exactly.
Too young at the time to do anything about it, and now, we're coming of age where we can show these people, that we did appreciate what they did, and we were there, even though we weren't able at the time, I think.
There's definitely been a new wave of patriotism in this country lately. Yeah. A lot of people are getting involved and being proud to be American again, and it certainly does our hearts good to see this. And it's something that, like everyone has said, is something really special to all of us, Frank. It's not the money. It's the thought. It's the love. It's the ability to be able to... When we were out in Colorado, there were a couple of fellows that walked out of the room, and one said, "Boy, that band is great." And the other one said, "What do you want? They're our band."
That said it all right there.
That is great.
Don, what would you like to see the Grunt Band do? How far would you like to see it cut an album? What would you like to see it do?
I like playing a lot. I'd like to see a bit more of the country. I'd like to meet more people. There's a lot of things happening with the vets all over the country. And I'd like to be there. I'd like to play more.
All right. It's not a once and done thing. It's not like we've gone and waved our flag and, now we're going home.
We play for them all, Frank.
Yeah, we will.
Yeah.
You could fit them all in one place. We play for them all.
Okay.
All they got to do is ask, Frank, and we'll be there.
Yep. Okay, now Dave, over to you. Before Caroline mentioned playing out in Denver, how did that happen?
Through someone that was on the Intrepid in New York, called an agent that we were working through with the band, and got us out to Colorado. And so we went. We went there. That's all it was. Basically, that was it.
It seems to be, the band seems to be pretty well received then. You've played there, you played on the Intrepid. Then
well, Denver, what happened on the Intrepid happened again in Colorado, isn't it?
As well as up in Hartford, New York.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That's the way you go. See, there's a lot of pent up, suppressed emotions of people.
You could actually travel all over the country to all 58 states. We added 8 more.
The Republic of Vietnam, there is no more.
That's including each individual Hawaiian island. So then, anyway, you traveled all 50 states. And,
I don't know about traveling all 50 states. We are dealing with other agents all across the country now to perform, in various parts of the country. It's not all, completely finalized, all the plans, but we will go back out on the road as the Grunt Band.
All right. Well, we have some more live footage of the band when they played out in Denver, and we're going to go to that tape right now, okay?
footage of the Grunt Band playing out in Denver. The song that you just saw before we came back to the interview was entitled Vietnam. And I'm going to ask Danny Greenberg about that song.
Well, Vietnam is a song that was originally written in 1971 by a fellow named Jimmy Cliff, who many people out there I'm sure have heard of if you're into reggae type music. Jimmy Cliff is an excellent musician and did a lot of things with Mick Jagger. And Bob Dylan has called this the greatest protest song in history. We're rewriting currently the words a little bit to sort of bring it up to date, but it hopefully, Frank, is going to be one of the songs that we're going to be releasing at the time when we do release our album.
Okay, what did you do in Vietnam then?
I was a medic.
I was with the 1st Air Cav, and I was there in 65, 66. I was actually with the 101st Airborne Division, but I was not on jump status when I was over in Vietnam, so I was in a leg unit. But I was medical specialist on 91 Bravo.
And this band is very close to your heart, isn't it?
Very much, very much so. The feeling, the magical feeling, the feeling of togetherness and the things that we bring is something that just can't be said in words. The Intrepid was such a magical time for all of us. The thoughts of myself coming out, really, after 10 years, and being proud to have served my country and have fought for my country and have my best friends around me at the same time, was just the most emotional experience, other than the birth of my children, that I've ever experienced in my life. I feel that that Vietnam will never be over for me or anybody like me, and this is a way to be able to share it with everybody out there in the United States, not only Vietnam veterans, but everybody that served the country and everybody that loves our country, Frank, because this is the moral of that.
It's really hard to get serious with you guys.
Too much. If we cracked up, too bad, everybody.
Way to go, Frank.
Nice
job.
Caroline Westphal.
Don Riker.
You remember?
Dan Greenberg. Glenn Schmidt.
Thank you all very much. This is Johnny Carson for Eddie Barron's
saying, see you on David Letterman.
Morning USA.
Some footage of us.